My name is Roland Schwarz. I'm a computational biologist at the European Bioinformatics Institute. The major part of my research is the development of new statistical approaches and computational methods for improving what is called phylogenetic inference, the reconstruction of the tree of life or parts of the tree of life. One of the most fascinating things about DNA for me is that it's digital and consists of these four characters, A, C's, T's, and G's. So it lends itself to the analysis with computational methods. And we're developing and improving those methods that look in DNA sequences for these changes. So we can say, in the course of evolution from animal 1 to animal 2, one of these A's, for example, at a certain position in the sequence has evolved to a C. I don't think there is really a typical day in my work. I think it really depends on the project you're working on. So even though I'm a computational biologist, not all of my time is spent in front of the computer. I think an important part of the projects that I do are meeting the collaborators, talking to people, to biologists, to the medics, to try to understand their point of view and their problems, but also withdrawing in a quiet corner to read some papers and try to get your head around a certain project and problem before you return to the computer and try to analyze the data and so on. One of the greatest things about my line of work, I think, is how interdisciplinary it is. So apart from my own line of research, I work with biologists, with clinical scientists, and every time I help them analyze their data, help them solve their problems, I myself learn a lot of new biology as well as a lot of new computer science and maths. I believe that careers are sort of evolutionary processes. In the same sense that random changes on the genome occur and give rise to all these new organisms, I think it has been random changes in my life that have made me first go into bioinformatics and then later end up here at the EBI in Cambridge. And so while I believe that you should have a rough idea of where you're going, I think you cannot prepare for the completely unknown. If I remember back in my days in school, while I enjoy certain subjects, of course, I always thought that learning was you learn for your parents or for your teachers or to have good grades. But then later, when I started doing my PhD, where I exclusively could focus on the actual research that I was interested in, suddenly I found it really exciting to learn new things. And I think that's one of the most rewarding things you can have in a job, is to get paid for learning.